Hi everyone, I'm Max Grover, and you're joining me in my studio today. Most of my painting does happen in this room, and I'm very at home, and it's very cozy for me to work in this space. I have just completed new work, and it's a little bit of a departure material-wise from what I usually do. I'm painting acrylic, and then on top of that, I'm painting oils, and I'm really happy with the effect that I'm getting from it. The themes are what I always do, and it's I take everyday objects and then show the extraordinary in the ordinary. I go out and make observations in the world and then bring them back to my studio and do my versions of them. So I'm not really looking at anything. Reality is not really important to me. I would, much rather show you something you've seen a million times in a way that you've never seen it before. And I think that this new work does accomplish those goals. So they're colorful, they're fun, they're whimsical. I was called a faux naive one time, and there's actually nothing faux about my naivety, though it's the real thing. I'm self-taught as an artist, and I took classes here and there, but I was in my early 30s when I decided that I'd had enough working for other people, and I had to figure out how to make a living and spend my time doing what I truly was passionate about. Writers write what they know, painters paint what they know. And this is exactly my world that gets put onto the boards and paper that I paint on. I have a fascination for plumbing. So that's gonna be showing up in some of this work. I also, in the past, have had a passion for vacuum cleaners, and I've done a lot of vacuum cleaner paintings. I like teapots, I like red cars, I like cats, and I love dogs. So all of these are things that end up in my paintings. And a lot of people see a nostalgia in my work, and which reminds them of their past, which is quite a compliment. And my cityscapes, they're of no place in particular, but somebody will look at it and go, I know that place, it's Detroit. I've been there, I've been on that corner, and it just comes from my imagination. But if people can connect to my paintings on any level, I've done my job. That's what I hope to do. I'm more interested today about the process than really the finished product. I am so enjoying the act of painting that I really do have a great love affair with that. When I was in high school, we had a fabulous art department at the high school I went to in Spokane. There was 5 full-time art teachers in that school. And my painting teacher, when I was a senior, took me to a college that was local and took me to the art department. She was encouraging me to pursue art at the time. And she took me into the painting studio, and I smelt the oil paint in that studio, and I knew then and there that I wanted to be a painter. It was so powerful to me, that that whole just being surrounded with the art that just was everywhere, and all the sensory things that it triggered in me. It took me a while to develop the discipline to be able to do this. And, you know, at the beginning, my first couple of hundred paintings probably looked like 200, you know, the first couple of hundred paintings, it looked like 10 different artists had painted them. I was going this way and this way and this way. And it takes a while for an artist to come out in their work. And I would go out for gallery walk in Portland, and there would be all these howling coyote paintings. And I would think, oh man, I got to paint some of those howling coyote paintings. And they weren't me. And so at the beginning, I kind of had to stop looking at a lot of other people's art because I was so greatly influenced by it. So eventually, the more I painted, the more I started to come out in my work.